Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, welcome guests. Breaking news. Passes table topics test. My first suggestion for Pass, after admiring a brilliant session and lovely idea, is that it would have been even better if you had read the topics yourself, because then we would have all heard them clearly. And one of my main suggestions to each of the speakers is that if you are reading your subject, please read it out aloud so that we can all hear the subject. It would help us. My second suggestion for Pass, when you do it next time, and you will do it next time, because each time we do it, we get better. When you do it next time, read the subject first before you announce the person who's going to do it. That will help too, because it will give everybody in the room a moment to think and a moment to worry, is it me? And so everybody is then involved in your session. And my final suggestion for you, Pat, is that apart from taking experienced speakers at the beginning, which will help you and will help the cause, if somebody who knows how to do it is the first speaker, that will be great. When you sign off at the end, this is as important as when you start at the beginning. A speech has a top and a tail. It starts with Toastmaster. And it finishes with that complete table topic session, Mr. Toastmaster, and you hand back the properly. And that etiquette is part of what we learn, part of what we teach, and it's part of what we learn, and it's part of what we transfer to our lives outside this room as well. So that's the table topic master. Cornelia, ambulances. Yes, very good. You talked about the doctors, you moved on to nurses, you moved on to troubles. I'm amazed that somebody who's here for the first time did this as well as she did it. Suggestions for her could be even better. Very small suggestions for her. And they're ones that we all know to avoid. They were the prop words, you know. And as soon as I mention it, we're going to stop doing that. Whatever. That's what my wife uses all the time.
Whatever.
Jill uses it. Maybe you don't. You don't? Okay.
Yeah, I know.
There we go, the end. The cliche. And a nice point for you. Use all the time in a speech. If you're given 2 minutes, use it for goodness sakes. Fill it up. And there are ways of doing that. I'll come on to it. On pilots. Again, lovely. Well done. Talked about India. Came up, first idea you thought of, went straight into it. And continued with the subject. The main point for Param is what something I've already alluded to. And that is, if you are reading the subject, read it so we can all hear it, fill your lungs and fill the room with the words and the beauty of your own voice. You start to enjoy your own voice. And we will enjoy you even more when you do that. Angela Hook. Angela knows how to do this. So she was talking about cancer in generic, and she knows that you come up here and you start the first idea that comes into your head, and she did that, and she talked about miracle cures. And then she moved on, slightly different aspect of it. We all want a miracle cure. And then she finished with an upbeat ending, a very optimistic ending. Angela, a very small thing for you. You've been left holding that piece of paper on which the headline was, and you spent the whole speech filling with it. And it would be so simple to just put it down and then use your hands to express yourself. Peter, the 13 monkeys. Fire. Peter gave us a near perfect example of how to handle a table topic. He came up and it split into three sections. That is a really good thing, to move to different scenes if you can. And I would add to that by suggesting that as you do so, have two other ideas in your head, apart from taking us to three different places. Give us noises, give us sounds about monkeys and on fire.
Nah.
So those are the ideas that I would add to Peter's. Raj, the boom over, wonderful subject, right close to my heart as well. And again, it's a subject where you could easily take this two or three different ideas. You could adopt the past, the present, or the future. You could adopt different types of property. There are many, you can talk about your own experience. There are so many different ways you could have taken us through that subject. And the idea, the way to do it, the discipline for this, is to start with that idea you first think of and use the time while you're comfortable with that idea to move, to work out where you're going to go with the speech. Speak louder and don't stand behind the lectern the whole time. When you're delivering a spontaneous speech, you're free. So use the free. And Joel Lansbury. The new year resolution relating to cancer, again, an expert on the field, took us straight away with a humorous line, but it depends on the resolution. And it landed, we all laughed. She then talked about real, is the headline real or not? There was a whole discussion about surveys related to her personal experience and conversations with her husband. And so on, through her speech. She took us all the way through to a very positive instruction at the end of her speech, cut out smoking. Outstanding. And I wish I had some suggestions for Angela, but all I can say is, be as good as Angela. That's my suggestion to the rest of us. So perhaps, as I say, I shall take my own advice, and I shall sign up properly. That completes my evaluation. Mr. Toastmaster!